Hello friends, today we are going to start the unit number 1, Electrodynamics, 502, unit number 1, Electrodynamics. In that, first topic is Ohm's law. So what is Ohm's law? So basically, any material has the constant resistivity and conductivity. So one material was material pass hai je che e conductivity and resistivity is a constant. Okay, and Ohm's law is applicable for only conductors. Conductor mate je che Ohm's law valid che, semiconductor ke insulator mate nothing. And the equation of Ohm's law is V is equals to IR, that we already know. So what is the V? V is nothing but the potential difference between the two ends. તમે જે કાંઈ વોલ્ટેજ આપણે બેટરી થ્રુ પડે જે એપ્લાય કર્યા હોય બરોબર, એટલે કે પોટેન્શિયલ ડિફરન્સ છે, એ પણ બે એન્ડ હોય છે, પ્લસ અને માઇનસ હોય છે. એન્ડ આઈ ઇઝ ધ કરંટ એન્ડ આર ઇઝ ધ રેઝિસ્ટન્સ. યુ કેન ગેટ ધ વેલ્યુ ઓફ ધ રેઝિસ્ટન્સ બાય પ્લોટિંગ ધ ગ્રાફ બિટવીન વોલ્ટેજ એન્ડ કરંટ ફોર કન્ડક્ટર્સ. ધ ગ્રાફ ઓફ ધ વોલ્ટેજ વર્સિસ કરંટ ઇઝ ઓલવેઝ લિનિયર ફોર કન્ડક્ટર્સ. And the slope of this graph is nothing but the resistance, that is R is equals to V upon I. Mainly V proportional to I, voltage is directly proportional to the current, and the proportionality constant is R. So R is the basically resistance of the particular material. So V is the voltage and its unit is volt. I is the current and unit is its unit is ampere, and R is the resistance and its unit is ohm. Okay. So we'll discuss about resistance or resistivity. There is a difference between resistance and resistivity. So first of all, R resistance is constant for every material. Correct, material mate R ni value given, material mate R ni value jo che a constant for. And then mainly for conductors, it is based on geometry. Geometry change thase to resistance change thase. Geometry means say area, length, sort of geometry. So change thase to resistance change thase. The relation between resistance and resistivity is R resistance. R is equals to rho L upon A, where rho is the resistivity, which can be constant for the any material. Resistivity જે છે કોન્સ્ટન્ટ છે અને જીઓમેટ્રિકલ ક્વોન્ટિટી નથી બરાબર, એટલે કોઈ પણ મટીરિયલ તમે લ્યો એનો શેપ કોઈ પણ હોય, લેન્થ કોઈ પણ હોય, રેઝિસ્ટિવિટી જે છે એ કોન્સ્ટન્ટ હશે. રેઝિસ્ટન્સ જે છે એ કોન્સ્ટન્ટ ઈ સેન્સમાં કે કોઈ પણ તમે એક મટીરિયલ લીધું તો એ મટીરિયલ માટે રેઝિસ્ટન્સ કોન્સ્ટન્ટ, પણ એની લેન્થ કે એની એરિયા જે છે ચેન્જ થશે તો રેઝિસ્ટન્સ ચેન્જ થશે, પણ રેઝિસ્ટિવિટી ચેન્જ થશે. સો resistance is a geometrical quantity, then the conductivity, and it is the inverse of the resistivity, or resistivity is the inverse of conductivity. So rho is equals to 1 upon sigma. If we put this value in the equation of resistance and resistivity, then we can get the R value of R is equals to L upon sigma into A, where sigma is the conductivity of the given material. So this is about the resistance. Now what about the current? So current is nothing but the flow of charge, mainly electrons. Current is nothing but the flow of charge. So how does charge flows in a given material? So you for that you have to apply the force on the charge. Current je che flow of electron je che e shu che ke jyare tame force apply karo charge par tyare je che current generate thashe. કરંટ પ્રોડ્યુસ થશે. ફોર્સ તમે નહીં એપ્લાય કરો તો કરંટ કોઈ પણ પ્રકારનો મટીરિયલની અંદર પ્રોડ્યુસ થશે. ઓકે, સો એન્ડ જેટલું તમે ફોર્સ વધારે એપ્લાય કરશો એટલું કરંટ વધારે જનરેટ થશે, કારણ કે એટલો ઇલેક્ટ્રોન અથવા ચાર્જ જે છે એ વધુ સ્પીડથી મોશન કરશે અને એટલે કરંટ વધુ હશે. ઓકે, ફર્સ્ટ ઓફ ઓલ કરંટ ડેન્સિટી, કરંટ ડેન્સિટી ઇઝ ધ આઈ અપોન એ, કરંટ અપોન એરિયા ઇઝ ધ કરંટ ડેન્સિટી. and that is directly proportional to force, applied force, and upon Q. So force upon Q means force per unit charge. F is force per charge, not unit charge. J is directly proportional to force per charge. So where J is the surface current density and F is the force per unit charge. If we take Q is equals to 1 and the proportionality constant is sigma, so J is equals to sigma F upon Q, and we take Q is equals to 1, so the J is equals to sigma into F, where sigma is the conductivity of a given material and it is inversely proportional to the resistivity of a given material. Okay, so J is equals to sigma F, J is the current density, sigma is the conductivity, and F is the applied force or force per unit charge. Okay, now here the current density, various current density, current per unit length, that is we can say one dimensional current, and it is given by I, current per unit area, and that is current density, area density, or a surface current density, and that is denoted as J, and current per unit volume, and that is the denoted as K. So these are the current density, one dimensional, two dimensional, and three dimensional. Okay, so now the resistivity is also varies with the variation which we vary the material. Different material mate resistivity je che e alag alag hase. For example, if we take silver, then its resistivity is very low. And if we take the graphite, so the resistivity of graphite is very high. And yes, for semiconductor, for example, diode, the resistivity is moderate, medium resistivity. It is greater than the resistivity of conductor, but it is lesser than the conductivity of the insulators. Okay, so this is the resistivity which varies with the variation in the sample. So now next is the Lorentz force, or we can say it is electromagnetic force. The equation of Lorentz force, F is equal to Q into E plus V cross V, where Q is the charge, E is the electric field, V is the velocity of charge, and V is the magnetic field. So a Lorentz force in magnetostatic, F is equal to Q into E plus V cross V. If it is the case of electrostatic, it means charge is steady, and if the charge is steady, so there is no velocity of charge, and if not no velocity of charge, then no magnetic field produced. So V and B both are zero, so the term V cross B will vanish, and the Lorentz force becomes F is equal to Q into E. So it is the case of electrostatic. So yes, now F is equal to Q into E, V cross B is equal to zero, Q is the unit charge, and J is equal to sigma into Q E plus V cross B. So now instead of the force, if we put the value of force from above equation, then we get J is equal to sigma into Q, because F is equal to J upon sigma. So J is equal to sigma into Q into E plus V cross B, if it is the case of the magnetostatic. Magnetostatic no case hoy, to apne aithe lakhi sakiye ke J is equal to sigma into Q into bracket E plus V cross B. So now again, it is the case of the electrostatic, then the term related to V and B, V cross B is zero. So for that case, J, current density J is equal to sigma into A. Okay. So this is nothing but the Ohm's law in electrodynamics. It is nothing but the Ohm's law in electrodynamics. In electrodynamics, the velocity of charge is there, but it is very low. So for that, we neglect the term, that is V cross B. Okay. So the equation of Ohm's law in electrodynamics is J is equal to sigma into E. J is the current density, sigma is the conductivity, and E is the electric field. And how it is related with the Ohm's law, general Ohm's law, which is the has the equation R is equal to V into I, or R is equal to V upon I, or V is equal to IR. So we have J is equal to sigma into E, we can write instead of sigma, we can write 1 upon rho. So j is equals to 1 upon rho into e. Now rho, if we rho je chhe ne samani side le jaiye to e is equals to so thi jase rho into j, e is equals to rho into j, and it is comparable with the general Ohm's law, v into ir, v is equals to ir. So here e is instead of e we have v, instead of j we have I, and instead of rho we have I. So it is comparable to the general Ohm's law, the equation of Ohm's law, v is equals to ir. Okay, thank you.